We are all on the journey to Bethlehem, and we have the great joy this morning of having our youth and children's choirs lead us in worship. Music is such an important part of a child's faith formation. Through song, the Word of God is written on their hearts. As they tell the Christmas story, they are also going to experience it. So we invite you to prepare your heart and mind to hear the story of Jesus' birth in a new way this morning, as the word is proclaimed through song.
Wonderful thing has happened here today, and we want to share it with you.
The Son of God has been born right here in Bethlehem.
As you might guess, Bethlehem is really buzzing.
The city was already full of people from all over the place who had come here to register their family with the government.
Our parents came to pay their taxes. That's why we're here.
Okay, let's not get political about it.
Yeah, Lillian, we're here to tell these people about what's been happening, so don't get off on that taxation stuff.
I'm sorry, but my dad says if they tax us anymore...
Lillian...
Sorry.
Now, back to telling you what's going on.
This is a wonderful story.
Jesus has been born!
Today! Hodiay!
We sing and
pay their taxes.
Did I tell you what my dad said about the taxes?
Most of these people in town this week are Jewish people, descendants of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. They were told for a long time that their God Jehovah would send a Messiah.
The Messiah would come and set the Jewish people free from all the different types of governments they had been under all these years.
In other words, they were waiting for someone to save them.
A savior.
And they knew about this Messiah who was coming because they had heard people talking about it for years and years.
Their preachers were called prophets. They were the ones who helped people understand what God was like and what God was going to do.
Engaged to this man named Joseph.
Ooh, my cousin was engaged to this boy from out of town. They were supposed to get married, but my cousin said that it just didn't work out, whatever that means.
And what does that have to do with this story?
It just reminded me how my cousin was engaged, like Mary and Joseph, you know?
Anyway, Mary had her baby while they were here in town to pay their taxes.
Did you say taxes? Okay.
This was Mary's first baby, of course, and she didn't know much about how to be a good mother.
But an angel told her she was going to be the mother of God's own son, so she had to learn pretty fast.
So when her baby boy was born, she held him close to her like she had seen other mothers do.
And you know what? She knew exactly what to do with her new baby.
To the world astray.
we heard about all this, we went running to the other side of Bethlehem to see what was going on.
All of us.
And when we got there, it was something else, let me tell you.
There were lots of people there to see the baby.
Jesus was sleeping on a bed of hay in a manger, remember? We sang, "Gentle Mary laid her child lowly in a manger," remember?
It's in spite of all the little crowd that had gathered, shepherds and common folk from around town, in spite of all that, everyone was really quiet.
Really quiet.
We didn't know what to do. Of course, I never know what to do.
So everybody did what they felt like doing, sort of like they knew it was they were in the presence of God's song and they should be themselves.
Some people knelt down on their knees like they were praying.
Others lifted up their hands toward heaven like they do in the temple.
And some of us danced.
How we happened to show up at the stable and see and hear all these things.
Or maybe you're wondering why the Romans are taxing the people like this.
We okay. were minding our own business until some shepherds came running down the street towards us.
They were praising God and telling everybody about this baby they had seen.
So that's how we found out. We heard it from the shepherds.
Thank you.
angels who heard it from the mouth of God. Oh yeah, I heard it from the shepherds who heard it from the angels who heard it from the mouth of God.
Oh yeah.
Fear not, fear not, fear not, the angel said, for behold, I bring you tidings of great joy, great joy, great joy that shall be to people everywhere. Unto you this day, this day, this day, Hodie, born in the city of David, Bethlehem, a Savior who is Christ the Lord. Hodie, this shall be a sign, a sign, a sign unto you. You shall find a baby wrapped in swaddling cloths, lying, lying in a manger. I heard it from the shepherds who heard it from the angels who heard it from the mouth of God. Oh yeah. I heard it from the shepherds who heard it from the angels who heard it from the mouth of God. Oh yeah. Fear not, fear not, fear not, the angel said, for behold, I bring you tidings of great joy, great joy, great joy that shall be to people everywhere. For unto you this day, this day, this day, Hodie, born in the city of David, Bethlehem, a Savior who is Christ the Lord. Hodie, this shall be a sign, a sign, a sign unto you. You shall find a baby wrapped in swaddling cloths, lying, lying in a manger. I heard it from the shepherds who heard it from the angels who heard it from the mouth of God. Hodie!
People in town were the only people to come to visit the baby Jesus.
No, eventually some wise men from far away came to see the baby.
I bet they weren't here to pay their taxes.
They'd been sent on a mission to find this particular child by King Herod. They'd seen a special star in the sky and knew that that was a sign that the Messiah had been born.
They followed the star to where the child was, and when they found him, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh, and bowed down to worship him.
Those are some pretty nice gifts.
The wise men had been warned in a dream not to tell King Herod where to find the child, so they were turned home in a different way.
Those wise men were pretty smart. Get it?
Ha ha.
Humor me a bit.
Following the shining star that's leading.
been a special day, all right.
For all of us.
And hopefully for you.
Angels, shepherds, wise men.
Mary and Joseph.
And a baby in a manger bed.
We've been a part of a wonderful story, the story of how God sent his people a Messiah, a Savior.
Jesus is born today. Now it's time for you to join the celebration.
Sing with us. Go out into God's world with the joy that you have heard this day from the shepherds and from the mouth of God. Try to get that tune out of your head. It is a joyful one to carry with you as we remember that God has come, the God who loves us more than we could ever imagine, who came to be with us, Emmanuel, God with us. Go with that joy today, and may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be and abide with you this day and always. Amen.